All right. So I basically have this hooked up. Let me get this in a good spot. There we go. Well, anyway, pretty much have this hooked up just to a speaker and a quick power supply and stuff, just so you could see the setup on it. I looked through it pretty quickly, but already for the price, I'm actually pretty amazed at what they put inside here, and it seems to work pretty well. There's definitely some programming issues here and there that you got to get used to. There's a lot of different things going on in here, but we'll get started. I have the dongle plugged in the back, and the only glitch I've noticed so far, I have this connected to my wireless in the house already, is that you seem to get this weird error, this device error, when it first boots, but that disappears, and then you still get connectivity. It pops up in the beginning, but serves no real issue. So there we go. We'll start it up here. The mechanism seems pretty stable, and when it locks to the back, it's pretty solid, so you have no problem touching the screen. There's no bouncing around and things like that. And you can also adjust the tilt forward and back. And there's that message I was telling you about, looking for a device driver. Like I said, this is Windows CE, and Jeeves basically comes with all sorts of software. They preloaded a lot of software into the micro SD card. Their new version of InnoSoft software, is pretty amazing, actually. Let me see if I can zoom in on the screen here for you a sec. So, pretty much, this is the InnoSoft software. This is actually on the micro SD card right now. There's an earlier version that's actually built into the resident flash as well. But this isn't actually the main program that you see in the manual. If you look in the manual, you'll have a whole different type of menu system. So it confused me at first, because you really don't get any instructions on this. You'll have to look up stuff on the internet about it, but from what I can tell, it is pretty cool, and the amount of software that they include built in here is impressive, to say the least. Obviously, this is your car radio. Oops. This is your car radio, so, you're not going to do tons of stuff, but you know what, if you're in your car a lot, this has pretty much almost every app I can think of in here. It looks like every menu can scroll and has different features built in. Already I've noticed, in addition to GPS and Bluetooth and the standard stuff, I noticed you can show the taskbar at the bottom, or you can disable it so it disappears. There's a 4 points type of a program where you can access volume, the keyboard, things like that. You can activate or deactivate. Got so much stuff. I barely gotten into it. But as far as my radio, this is where it started up for me. If I didn't have the SD card plugged in, it would pretty much go to the main menu. I can show you now. If I hit the mode button twice, I believe it was. Hold on. And this is actually the background. You can access pretty much everything in here. There we go. You can access pretty much everything in here. I think they'll let you modify almost anything you want. I've only seen one other review online about this radio, and it was just a brief forum mention, and the guy happened to say that this thing was horrible and had a horrible UI and everything. And from what I can tell, it's actually 30 times better than the Chinese knockoffs that are the same price as this. The only difference is this doesn't have a DVD player built in. You have your radio. You can save settings. If I change stations for whatever, you can just hit save, and it saves it on the side here. Or you can discard it with a little garbage can. Really nice feature, I think, because it makes it easy. It looks like you can save quite a bit on here. You can probably scroll through. Didn't get that far, but obviously you can go forward and backward. There's also manual entry keyboard to enter a direct access number, two FMs and AM, pretty basic. Go back to the home screen here. New movies. I will say I have a couple of movies on here that load pretty fast and they play, but on the action scenes, they seem to get a little bit on the jumpy side. You know, maybe because this is, you know, reading off the card and stuff. I don't know if a better card might help that or not. But that's basically what I come across anyway. You go, of course, can go full screen, and it seems to work pretty nice. What else? Let's see, I don't want to drag you through too much here. So let's close that. Movies. Music, I loaded some music onto the card there. I'm so used to swiping, the menu screen doesn't have any kind of a feature like that, but it does have the side menu buttons, so you can scroll up and down, pick a certain song, things like that. Nice EQ that seems to be accurate. It's not just one of those graphic things that actually seems to correlate to the song, which is pretty cool. Doesn't seem to have thumbnails. I have a couple of songs in here with thumbnails that didn't show them. Doesn't mean it's not in here, but so far I haven't found that. You can shuffle, go straight through, you know, repeat, rewind, all that kind of stuff. And they have volume built in here as well as, you know, built in here. Haven't figured out a way to get rid of the beeping noise yet. Some people like that, I don't. But I'll figure that one out later. Let's see. Anything so far that I've gone into, and if you just go back to the homepage, keeps playing in the background, no problem, to the point I've even connected a Bluetooth phone call and went to the main page and started playing a game while I'm on the phone with somebody, which I've never seen a radio be able to do. Trick is you still have to get back into the other side of that menu to hang up, where you hang your phone up manually. Let's see. We got photos. I just have... You can search on board, the 2 gigabytes on board, or you can search through the card, of course. Oops. It does seem to take a little while to read off the card. Like I said, odds are I might just end up getting a 32 gig high, a high class rate card, and that probably give me everything I need to do. Pretty cool. It'll flip through pictures and things like that. I think if you double tap, it goes back to the menu. If I'm not mistaken. Actually, no, I'm on the smaller screen. Hold on. I think it was down below here. Still haven't figured this thing out. There we go. Yeah, if you double tap on the side or something. But while it's loading pictures, it kind of gets slow. Not bad, though. Pretty cool. Let's see. iPod, unfortunately, I don't have an iPod with me anyway, so I don't have any way to test that right now, but I'll probably put another quick video up online once I get it in the car, and I get somebody's iTouch and hook that up. I'll show you games here. Just pick one of them. They got Tetris, they got some chess thing or whatever. Sounds like something good when you're stuck in traffic, maybe. but anyway, these are kind of built into the menu, so they're easy. You just hit off and it goes right out of them pretty quickly. These are built into the main menu, I'll say, because it seems that InnoSoft software kind of makes it confusing as to what's the original menus. You have Explorer, which pretty much looks like it'll let you run and move things around from one folder. This is showing the SD card folder right now. You can do various standard operations. If you have a flash card installed or USB, things like that, it'll read that stuff too. It seems like this version of the good thing is this version of Windows 6 seems to have most of the drivers to handle a lot of different drives and things like that. Supposedly can handle up to a terabyte portable drive plugged in as well. So there's a lot of possibilities there. What else we got here? Now, the InnoSoft, of course, if I hit that, that's going to go right back to this. Or the earlier version, which is, I'm not going to show just because it's an earlier version. Similar to this, but doesn't have anywhere as many features on it and things like that. To exit out of this, and if you hit the mode button, it'll take you back to the main menu again. Bluetooth, you got. I think I auto-connected already, which is seems to be working pretty well. Some phones, some of these radios don't seem to auto-connect very well to the radio, but this one seems to work. Let me see. I have it hooked up to Slacker radio, so I don't know if it's going to keep playing or not now, since I reconnected, but... Yep, there it is. So, end of a song. So that's pretty cool. This, I believe, supports thumbnails, but my phone actually doesn't. So, what are you gonna do? So anyway, as far as controls and everything, it seems to work good with that. I seem to stream a lot off my phone, so I'll probably use that feature quite a bit, which is why I showed it. Pairing, of course, gives you a certain timeout so you can repair with devices. Of course, I just re-disconnected here. We'll connect again here. Seems to work pretty well as far as connecting and disconnecting and things like that. I haven't had any issue. It seems to pair up pretty nicely. I do like the phone book. If I hit the sync button now, it'll just keep trying to sync, and it just kept going. It kept starting to grab all my contacts and everything off of here pretty nicely. I'm not gonna get into a phone call because it's pretty basic. Although I will say that the microphone built into the front of the unit here. Let me go back here. You got that little mic just built right in the front there. It actually works pretty well. I did a couple of quick test calls in the house. I mean, obviously road noise is one thing. My car is pretty quiet, but microphones seem to pick up really clear. So for the most part, I think that worked pretty nice. Has all the usual stuff. Picks up, you know, recorded calls and last calls and all that kind of stuff. Let's see. Obviously, there's settings and stuff in there. And of course, once you exit the Bluetooth, you know, you go back to the radio, just the way it was. Let's see, what else? Geez, you can shut off the screen. There's also, I'll show you real quick, there's also a quick power off button. So you hit power and it'll just sit there and show you the clock, which I thought was pretty nice. I don't know if it'll do AM, PM, I haven't checked, but I did just set the time briefly. If you turn it back on, it's like it's on standby, so it comes right back to where you were, which is nice. You got the settings. There's actually three pages of settings, seemingly all pretty legitimate settings, not just a bunch of garbage. Last page is just the brake check to check your brake switch. Check your camera, aux inputs, your steering controls. Lights, you can change the coloring of the lights to pretty much whatever you want. I'll just come up here so you can see. Pretty cool. And you actually even have a color changing mode. Let's see if that's changing. Yeah, slow change in color. Pretty cool though. I didn't know it even had that feature, so that's pretty nice. You can actually make notes, calendar, calculator. Might come in handy, who knows? That's a major calculator. Probably something Windows based. Let's see, we got date, time, you can set up the navigator location, so you can use any navigation program you want. This will show you the GPS lock and signal and stuff. I have it just kind of sitting inside the house, but it's still locking damn good. It is an SIRF4, which is a step up from any of the other ones. Pretty much all the others I've seen were 3, so that's pretty cool. Wallpaper, you can basically pick any file you want. There's ones built in. This is actually one of my own pictures that I loaded in there just to see if it worked. And it does work. I mean, you can see it in the background, and that's awesome because most of them you can't get that, you can't modify that much. Tons of languages, volume. I have the chime in the background, which you can shut off, so it won't chirp at you anymore. Backlight, you can actually set how bright you want the backlight normally, and also when your car lights are on, which is really nice, because I'm not too good at night, so I like it all the way down. Let's see what else we got. Navigator. We pretty much got everything. And subwoofer, which most of them don't give you the separate sub, and then all your settings for different options. You can pick, you know, your balance and all that kind of stuff, or hit the default and it'll go right in the middle again. I think they did an excellent job on the software, to be honest with you, and for the price, it's pretty nice. So that's pretty much it. Navigation is the last thing. Don't know what software they might give you with yours. I paid a little bit of extra so I can get the USA maps, supposedly authentic. This is the Finian GPS, which seems to work pretty good. And, you know, locked onto my position nice and quick, tells me what street I'm on and everything. You show the clock in the corner or not. This is all just software-based stuff, but seems to work pretty nicely. And I guess that's about it. Next time I'll do a quick video and show you guys it into my car and see how it works out. All right. Thanks a lot.